Hi friends, today I am going to explain you about dictionary techniques. Okay, there are two dictionary techniques, that is first is static and second is adaptive. These techniques build a list of commonly occurring patterns and encode them by transmitting their index in list. First we will see about static dictionary technique. This technique is suitable when we have prior knowledge about the source. For example, we have to compress the students' records of college. A static dictionary technique can be used here. And this will be best approach because we already know that certain words like name, student ID, which comes frequently in all of our records. Okay, second dictionary technique is adaptive dictionary technique. Adaptive means we can also say as dynamic, and there are three approaches, that is first is LZ77 approach, second is LZ78 approach, and third is LZW approach. We will see one by one. First we will see the LZ77 approach with example. First I am going to explain you what is the LZ77. Okay, first we will see. Okay, this is the LZ77 approach. We use one window, that is sliding window, and that consists of two parts, that is first is search buffer and second is lookahead buffer. Here you can see that orange part we consider as the search buffer, and that is denoted by S, and second part, that is in blue color, that is lookahead buffer. And here I am using pen. Okay, here I want to show you this whole length, that is W. So we can say this part lookahead buffer is our W minus S. Okay, now we will see what is meant by search buffer. This search buffer is the portion of the recently encoded sequence, and lookahead buffer is the next portion of the sequence to be encoded. Okay, with example we can explain you further. Okay, here is one sequence we have given, that is C A B R A C A D A B R A R R A R R A D. This is the total sequence, text sequence we have to encode. For that, okay, here you can see this is the match pointer, because we have to match with this. Match the character in the lookahead buffer with search buffer. Okay, and here it got the match, and this is the distance between this lookahead buffer and search buffer match pointer, and that distance is called as offset. And this is the length we are getting, that is length L. You can see here this A B R A A B R A, this length of 4 characters match we get here. And what is the offset? The offset is the distance of the pointer from the lookahead buffer, it's called the offset. Okay, now we have to encode that sequence like this. We have to write that code word as OLC. O is offset, then L is length of match, and C is our code word for next symbol. Okay, this is one example. That is, suppose we have sequence to be encoded, that is kabra kadabra RRA RRAD. The length of the window is 13, and the lookahead buffer we have given as 6. So the length of the search buffer will be W minus L, that is 13 minus 6, that is 7. So this orange boxes R7, and this looped buffer, that is blue boxes, are 6. Okay, now we have to match, we have to search for the match for the this D character, but there is no match getting in our search buffer, that's why there is no match. So that is offset will be 0, and L will be also 0 because there is no match, and this C code is for the next symbol, that is, that's why we write as C of D. Okay, next step is move the window by one character, because we are not getting match in the step 1, that's why we are moving our window by one character. Okay, here you can see we move that our window by one character, and here you have to remember that search buffer length and this looked buffer length will be the same, that is, here is 7 of search buffer and length of the looked buffer is 6. Okay, now we will see whatever character in the looked buffer, first we have to match with this in search buffer, that's why I'm using pen. I want to show you. Further, we are getting match with A, that is second character, but we have to search for the more match, that's why here also we can get, but here we are getting more match, that's why we are choosing that. Okay, you can see here we are getting this looked buffer character A match with this search buffer in A, and there is an offset of 7, because you can see here there are 7 characters, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, so our offset is 7 and match length, that is 4, because A, B, R, A match with this A, B, R, A, so length is 4, you can see here length is 4, that's why the code word is, see here the code word is 7 comma 4 comma C of R, that is for the code for the next symbol, that is R. Okay, next, that is step 3. In this step 2 we are getting 4 matches, that's why we are moving our window by 5 character. Okay, here you can see. Now for the character R, we are getting in the search buffer R, we are getting the match, and here the length is 3, that is R A R, that is R A R, length is 3. Okay, in this step 3 we are also getting for this R in looked buffer only we are getting match. How? We can see here you can see that is R match with this R. Okay, and also this A match with this A, and here you are getting length is 2, that means our offset is 3 but length is 5, that is 3 plus 2, that is 5, and the code is C of D. I hope you understand this LZ77 approach, and if you have any doubts, comment below the description box, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.